Hey YouTube. Well, we just got by July 4th and had a couple of videos I was going to put up, but I had a train wreck on both of them. On pork belly, cooked too hot, didn't want to upload that, and I had some dogs and burgers on the 4th, and my phone got overheated where I had it clamped closer to the grill than it needed to be, and it shut off on me. So today, to make up for that, I'm going to do a little short one on some ball peanuts. You know, it's summertime around July 4th, and around here we eat watermelon, home churned ice cream, and ball peanuts. I went by the farmer's market this morning, picked up about 6 pounds of raw peanuts right out of the field. So what I'm going to do is get my old pressure cooker out and clean them up, wash them, soak them a little bit, and then we're going to put them in that canning pot and put them under pressure for about 1 hour and 20 minutes. Add some salt and some spices, and they're going to be some good boiled peanuts. If you're from the South, you know what I'm talking about. Some people don't like boiled peanuts. They like roasted. I like them too. Ballpark, you know, parched, roasted peanuts. Salted, but boiled peanuts is where it's at. Give me a Coke and a bag of boiled peanuts and watch the ball game. So stand by. Hey folks, went out to the farmer's market, bought about 6 pounds of peanuts, raw peanuts, green, whatever. We're gonna put them in a pressure cooker today and got them all washed up and clean, de-stemmed, letting them sit in some hot water and soak up some water in the raw skins for a little bit while I get everything else ready. Got my old pressure cooker. It's a big one. Had to clean it up. That handle's broken, but it's okay. Still works real good. It's an old one. Got me some water here with some salt and seasoning in it. So we're gonna try it. Love boiled peanuts. Some people don't like them, but if you live in the South, you like them. Well, I'll be back. Okay, just dip them out into your colander and get them ready for the boiler. Okay, we got them in the pot. Now I get to put the lid on. Lid's on. Now it's time to wait for that pressure to build up. This is an old Presto 16 quart canner. I've done a lot of canning in it over the years. So I've got about 6 pounds of peanuts in it, and it'll take about 1 hour and 20 minutes, something like that. We cut it off and let the pressure die down. All right, check back in a little bit. Had a little change in plan. My 16 quart canner has been sitting so long, probably several years, the gasket has dried out. It wouldn't seal for pressurized cooking. So I'm using it just as a boiler, and I got my 6.5 quart out and divided some into it, and it will work because we use it quite frequently with other things. So that's what's going on right now. It's taking a little longer than I thought, but we'll get there. Stay tuned. Well, the timer's going off. They've been on about 1 hour and 20 minutes. So cut the heat off and let the pressure die down. We'll have us some boiled peanuts. Salty boiled peanuts. All right, we got one pot here. Pressure's down. Still hot though. I'll open it up and see what it looks like. have to let these go a little bit longer. These are the ones that didn't get under pressure, but they were boiling. I'm just checking one of them. Yeah. Pretty good. Could use a little more salt. What do you do in that case is put some more salt in it. While that water's still hot. And just let it sit in it. Let these peanuts just sit in this hot water. And it'll soak it up. How much salt you get in these hulls and in the peanut itself is critical. And after you cook them, if they're not salty enough, you can add salt. These are good peanuts, they're full. Sometimes you can get a load and there's just a lot of pops and juice and not enough peanut meat. I'll just let it, I'll let that one stay on a little bit longer. This other one, still got some pressure on it, letting it work down. Make sure if you're using pressure canners, always let that pressure off. You have a dial on them that'll show zero pressure, but you can tell if you do that, you still got a lot of pressure on. Don't ever open that pot lid, or you'll have a steam bath in your face and it can scald you. So most people know that, but there have been a lot of people over the years. Years ago, I used to hear about it when they were more popular with vegetable canning. But always let that pressure go down to zero. And the way you tell, if I could lift that up and it doesn't steam, you know the pressure's gone. Same thing on this big one. It has a weight. And if you can pull that off and there's no steam, you know the pressure's, and the gauge goes down to zero. I know there's no pressure on this one because the seal didn't seal off where it could build up the 15 pounds. So I just use it as a boiling pot until I can replace the seal on the gasket on the lid. All right, check back with you in a little while. Show you the end result.
Okay, we got this smaller pot. And we've got the pressure off of it. And let's check two or three of these. I want to check and see if they need any more salt.
I can tell those being under pressure for an hour and 20 minutes, the hull is softer. Okay, this you can tell these are a little more done. They're not juicy, but they've got enough salt. I think the salt's there. They just need to maybe sit in the water for a while and soften up that hull a little bit more. Salt's just right. I put some Lowry seasoning in there with the salt. Just thought I'd try it. All right, these aren't Cajun like Russ Jones makes, but they're good. Russ has the rocket pots going. I don't have a rocket pot, but this will work just fine. Even a boiling pot, it'll do it. I'll come back one more time after the final results. Okay, here we go. This is the final tally. They look good. This is the big pot. Yep, they picked up some more salt. They needed it. There we go. There is your boiled peanut. You don't know what they look like. And what they taste like. You can't, it's like potato chips, you can't eat just one or two. You got to sit down and eat a whole big bowl of them. So, go to the farmer's market, get you some peanuts, some raw peanuts, green, they call them green peanuts, they're raw, just came out of the field. Take them home, take about 3 pounds and at least a half a cup of salt and some seasoning, Lowry's seasoning or whatever kind of seasoning you want to use. Just another little extra kick. Put in there and boil them for about 2 hours just in a regular pot, or if you have a pressure cooker, you boil them under pressure for about an hour and 20 minutes and they'll be just fine. Let them sit in the water maybe for 30 more minutes and cool down, and then put them in the colander. And you can bag them up and freeze them actually, and take a bag out once in a while all the way to Christmas. Or you can just eat them. All right, that's my video. Hope you enjoyed it. And this is Phil and Florence, and I'll catch you on the next one.
Ooh-wee, look at there. Ball peanuts. You got to be in the deep south to appreciate this. Anyway, I got me a couple of bowls, one for me and one for Mama. We're going to sit down and just enjoy these with ice cold beer, ice cold Pepsi, ice cold iced tea. Your pick. This is what we do. Salty bowl peanuts. I used to sell these when I was a kid. Miss Ham over in Sumter would go out to the farm and buy a bunch of them and bring them back to her house on the back porch, and she'd boil them up, and all the little 10, 12, 14 year olds around town would come up there and get about 50 bags of them and hit the streets. 10 cent a bag. Salty bowl peanuts. 10 cent a bag. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little short video. Brought back a lot of memories, and we're getting ready to chow down. If you haven't tried them, you need to. Go get you some. Phil and Florence.